Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. Sponsored by Lee Valley and Veritas. With over 5,000 high-quality woodworking hand tools, visit their online catalog at leevalley.com.
Want to split this. But of course, so does this huge knot right down there. Now one way would be to just cross-cut it here, but I wanted to try to get a big serving spoon. As I look at this, all of this is, can you see this stuff here? These bumps and things, these are various knots and broken branches. That's all going to turn that section into firewood. But on this face, it's got some pretty clear stock in there. And this was either headed to the landfill or firewood anyway, so I'm doing it a favor. Giving it another life. Except. Now I feel like, did any of you see Roy's things?
Yeah.
That knot is there. Not want that to split. So I would have to cut that off. Because the knot wants to keep it together. Now I brought a brand new saw from Lee Nielsen here. It comes already mucked up, but it's got all this residue all over it. But a nice little hole to hang it from. And yeah, I got it at that outlet store, at Pottery Barn. I forgot a real saw, and I keep this in the car for when I'm driving along and see good spoonwood by the side of the road. You can get out quick and nobody can hear you and then you can get back where you're going. Do this stuff while the wood is wet because it cuts more easily then. You can do it when they're dry and let me know how that goes.
Slow.
Slow is right, yeah. And some of these woods that I like to use, they don't last well in the log. They'll decay. The sapwood will discolor. It's green woodworking, and we'll talk more about that as if I ever get this one open. Now we're going to get some. That is their fro, for real. So that's the chunk with the knots and stuff. And this one looks pretty good, but it's huge. So I'm going to gamble and split it again tangentially. All right. So that's enough of that. Now, this one is very thin out here, but that's fine. This is still, you know, grossly oversized, but even for a serving spoon. So I'll grab a hatchet. And we'll start to look at how do you see the spoon in that. Down like that. And flip it end for end. So I'm just starting to dress the sides of this to get a blank. If you've ever worked wood from an apple tree, then you know it's just a lovely material to work with, just fabulous stuff. So now I'm going to take away the bark. Same story as before. And all of this is really just so I can start to see where I'm going. Sometimes you choke up on the hatchet, get a little more control. Sometimes you rear back to get a bigger swing. Here, and I don't want to hit that. It happens now and then. The goal is to have that happen very soon, very early on in the process. So you can just throw it away. You don't want to be throwing away 15 minutes of work when you can throw away 5 minutes of work. And so these are pretty light cuts. And they break out at your saw cut. I keep holding it to you instead of to the camera. And I'm choking way up on the hatchet and taking a lighter swing, and then right there near the saw cut, twisting the head that way. Like that. So that'll break at that depth stop. Right? Make sense? You guys can hear me in the back? So then going this way, it's easy, because you want to just run it all the way to the tip of the handle. And the bowl gets in the way. Then I have these notches. Can you bring us way over to here? I cut a notch in the edge of the stump. And I can lay it down in that notch. And that helps steady it from beginning to cut that profile, that shape of the bowl. Now this also gives me room to get in here. I use both of those methods. Some pieces, I use the saw to make those relief cuts. Particularly if it's a weirdo grain, like that lilac that I'm working these days, that stuff grows so unruly that you sometimes can't predict where it's going to split. So this still looks like a huge Fred Flintstone club or something, but it's beginning to get its shape. Sketch my shape again. And now I'll just do one more refinement and then send this around so you can look at it up close.
Thanks for watching. To find even more videos and woodworking related content, be sure to visit our website at mattsbasementworkshop.com. You can also find us on Facebook, Twitter, and Google+. And don't forget to subscribe to the show either on YouTube, in iTunes, or you can even receive email notifications whenever we post something new.